Hey, this is Mike in the Film Lab on the Substream.com, and this is part two of our gear guide episode made in conjunction with the super cool dudes at White's Interactive. Today, like is in part one, we're looking at the Fig Rig, which is a really cool solution if you're shooting DSLR or a little mini HDV camera on how to stabilize your footage without hiring a super expensive Steadicam type guy. And in the first video, we talked about what a Fig Rig is, basically how it works in principle. And today, we're gonna have a special, like all my favorite videos on YouTube where guys open boxes of hockey cards, the unboxing video. This is the box, this is the Fig Rig. Got it from White's Interactive, super pumped. If you have like two pennies rubbed together, go rent one of these, because they work really well and they're super affordable. So here's what's in the box. To start, the first thing you do is you take out the stand, which is this cool tripod thing that just flips out like that and locks into place, which gives you eventually a place to rest the Fig Rig when you're not shooting with it. This is the main kind of bus steering wheel thing. The adapter plate's already locked in, so we'll take that out so we can put our camera in later. First thing you wanna do is be able to put this down. So you take this red clamp out. It's got some wear so you can see where it goes. Loosen this all the way so you can slide it up and put it in place. Lock it down. Find this piece, a standard piece of grip gear. You'll find these in a lot of different kits because they're good for doing a lot of different things. They're really easy to lose, but they're expensive to replace once you start losing them, so don't lose them. It goes in here like so. And then what you can do, once you have that in, if you loosen this, you put this in here so you have a place to hold it. So now we're gonna build the rest of this. This is a basic Fig Rig set. You could then shoot like that, but White's, because they're cool, have included a bunch of other value-added stuff into the kit, namely this LED light panel, which is probably the most expensive to buy piece of equipment in the case, maybe other than the custom case itself. This thing runs off batteries. It's one of these deals. We're gonna have another gear guide video on how to use these LED light panels because they're still relatively new. It comes with these little diffusion things that snap in, or CTO. But how do you get it on the Fig Rig? This is the neatest part of the kit. It's made by Manfrotto, who make the Fig Rig as well. They've got this neat technology, which is called a hydrostatic arm. A 3/8 inch thread there, a screw head there that can go into the bottom of the light, like so. This is all locked, but if you unlock this knob, the whole thing gets flobby. See that? Every part of it gets loose. See how neat that is? That's so cool. Everything gets flobby just by doing one thing. So then you put it in the place where you want it, you lock it up, and it's all locked again. Such a cool thing. So then what you do, you take one of the two nano clamps, and you find the 3/8 inch thread, which is there, male to female. Then you unlock the hydrostatic arm. You open up this guy. You come over here, tighten that down. Get it where you want it. And lock it off. And then you have your light mounted on the top of there. It also comes with a hot shoe adapter. A lot of accessories for DSLR cameras obviously make use of the hot shoe mounting system. Lights, microphones, mixers, stuff like that. You combine it with the other little nano clamp, like so, and you're able to have that hanging off there. If you're an old dinosaur and you're not shooting with a DSLR, if you're shooting with a Panasonic or a Sony HDV cam, we call the guys at White's Interactive to find out exactly what cameras that is that I'm talking about. You can actually rent these little things that go mount on here that plug right into the camera, and you can use that to control, you know, zoom and aperture and stuff like that, and focus with your two thumbs while you're doing that. They haven't invented that with the DSLR because the DSLR is not necessarily a mature video making platform yet, but trust me, it's coming. The last thing is the base plate, which is neat. It goes in, it's got a 3/8 inch thing right there. But the neat part is, you press this little rubber grommet, it pops out. You can slide this out, you can put a 1/4 inch screw in instead, depending on what your camera uses. This screws in like so, come around here, slide it in. Once you hear it click, you know it's in far enough. You lock it off using this lever here. And then loosen this guy down here, lift it out, turn on our light. Look at that, we're good to go. So that's what comes in the Fig Rig kit, and that's how to put it together. It's really easy to figure out once you know how it all kind of works. They work really well. Talk to White's Interactive about getting your hands on one, because they're